हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी मर्चेंट ऑफ वेनिस एक्ट टू सीन सेवन। वी आर टेकिंग एक्ट टू सीन सेवन इमीडिएटली आफ्टर एक्ट टू सीन टू बिकॉज बोथ दी सीन्स आर इंटरकनेक्टेड विद वन अनदर एंड इट्स ईजी टू अंडरस्टैंड वेन वी स्टडी इट दिस वे। दिस इज द फर्स्ट ऑफ द थ्री सीन्स वेर अ सूटर मेक्स हिज चॉइस ऑफ द थ्री कैसेट्स। हियर The Prince of Morocco is attracted by the gold cusset which says, Who chooseth me shall gain what many men desire. He is dazzled by the outward appearance of gold and chooses the wrong cusset which contains a skull. Thus, he loses the lottery and leaves at once with a heavy heart. Portia is relieved of having got rid of a suitor whom she does not like. If we remember the scene previously, what we have studied, the time Morocco enters into the scene, as soon as he enters into the scene, what does he say? Mislike me not for my complexion. He is talking of his outward appearance. And here too, when he makes his choice, he goes for the outward appearance and what is written on the cassette. He goes for the gaudy appearance of the gold, the shiny appearance of the gold, and the line, the sentence written on that, Who chooseth me shall gain what many men desire. This brings out the personality of Morocco, that he is attracted towards the outward appearance. Even while he was boasting about himself, he was talking about all his outwardly qualities of how brave he is and how handsome his people think he is, and how the maidens of his clime, they would all fall in love with him. All what he was talking about was his qualities which show his outward strength, his outward beauty. And that's how he makes a choice for the outward appearance of the gold. Scene 7, Belmont, a room in Portia's house. Flourish of cornets. Enter Portia with the Prince of Morocco and their train. Portia, go, draw aside the curtains and discover the several cassettes to this noble prince. Now make your choice. To whom is Portia talking here? To whom does Portia say, go draw aside the curtains? Of course, it would not be the Prince of Morocco. She is addressing it to one of her servants, or perhaps to somebody who is very close to her. Go draw aside the curtains and discover. What do you mean by discover? Show or disclose the several cassettes to this noble prince. Now make your choice. Then the last part of a dialogue is addressed towards the Prince of Morocco when he says, now make your choice. That line is addressed to Morocco. Morocco, the first of gold, who this inscription bears, who chooseth me shall gain what many men desire. The second, silver, with this promise cries, who chooseth me shall get as much as he desires. And the third, dull lead, with warning all as blunt, who chooseth me must give and hazard all that he hath. How shall I know if I do choose the right? So the first thing that appears to Morocco is what is written on the cassette. He looks at the cassette, he identifies the gold cassette, the silver cassette and the lead cassette. He reads the inscription written on that. What is written on the gold cassette? Who chooseth me shall gain what many men desire. And on the silver it was written, who chooseth me shall get as much as he deserves. And on the lead cassette it was written, who chooseth me must give and hazard all that he hath. Hazard means willing to take risk. So, on the three cassettes,
there were words which were engraved describing the cassette. So he very plainly, very blankly puts the question to Portia, how would he know that he has chosen the right cassette? What sign would be there inside the cassette, or what sign would be there to indicate that he has chosen the right cassette? Portia answers saying, the one of them contains my picture, Prince. If you choose that, then I am yours with all. Morocco, some god direct my judgment. Let me see. I will survey the inscription back again. What says this leaden cassette? Who chooseth me must give and hazard all he hath. Must give? For what? For lead? Hazard for lead? This cassette threatens men that hazard all do it in hope of fair advantages. A golden mind stoops not to show of dross. I'll then not give nor hazard aught for lead. What says the silver with a virgin hue? Who chooseth me shall get as much as he deserves. As much as he deserves? Pause there, Morocco, and weigh thy value with an even hand. If thou best rated by thy estimation, thou dost deserve enough, and yet enough may not extend so far as to the lady, and yet to be afeard of my deserving be but a weak disabling of myself. As much as I deserve, why, that's the lady. I do in birth deserve her, and in fortunes, in graces, and in qualities of breeding. But more than these, in love I do deserve. What if I strayed no further, but choose here? Let's see once more this saying graved in gold. Who chooseth me shall gain what many men desire. Why, that's the lady. All the world desires her. From the four corners of the earth they come to kiss this shrine, this mortal breathing saint. The Hyrcanian deserts and the vasty wilds of wide Africa, Arabia, are as though thoroughfares now for princes to come view fair Portia. The watery kingdom, whose ambitious head spits in the face of heaven, is no bar to stop the foreign spirit. But they come, as over a brook, to see fair Portia. One of these three contains her heavenly picture. It's like that lead contains her. It were damnation to think so base a thought. It were too gross to rib her surcloth in the obscure grave. Or shall I think in silver she's immured, being 10 times undervalued to tried gold? O sinful thought, never so rich a gem was set in worse than gold. They have in England a coin that bears the figure of an angel, stamped in gold, but that's inscribed upon. But here an angel in a golden bed lies all within. Deliver me the key. Here do I choose, and thrive I as I may. So Morocco has a long talk with himself. After going through the three cassettes, he talks to himself. He is an open-minded person. He is an open person. He is open to himself, and he is talking out loud and clear. Look at the way he first says that some god direct my judgment. When he says some god, it shows very clearly that he has no faith in God actually. It's a sort of a mockery. He doesn't address his prayer to a particular god, to God as one. But he says some god, koi bhagwan mera. Some, when he says, see, when work is given, work, whenever we give work, we give a work to a particular person. We assign the work to someone. And when you assign the work to someone, it is sure that it will be done. For example, when a teacher says someone must close the windows of the class, so that someone
can be anyone from the number of students that we have in the class. But if a teacher says that, okay, Sam, you must close that window. So Sam is made in charge of closing the window. He is made responsible of closing the window, and Sam closes the window. But when it is said someone closed the window, someone may or may not close the window. In the same way here, when Morocco says some God direct my judgment, he is just saying it for the sake of saying it. It shows that he is confident, or rather he is overconfident in his own abilities. And he then goes and surveys the cassette once again. He says again, he goes and reads what is written in the leaden casket. He goes first to the leaden casket and he says, who chooseth me must give and hazard all he hath. See here what the leaden casket is saying. The one who chooses must be ready to take risk and must be ready to give everything that he has. That's the plain version of it. So Morocco says, must give for what? For lead. Hazard for lead. Now, Morocco is offended by the statement written here. He says, to give for what? For lead. Hazard for lead. One thing we must remember here, Morocco hasn't come to win the cassettes. He has come here to win Portia. It is Portia who is at stake, and the entire property of Portia that is at stake. So if you're willing to give to Portia, if you're willing to take risk of Portia, then choose this cassette. It was not meant that choose the cassette for the sake of the cassette's value. But here Morocco, again, he goes by the outward appearance and what's written on the cassette. He presumes that what he is choosing, he's choosing the cassette and not for Portia. That's why he makes the statement. The cassette threatens men that hazard, all do it in hope of fair advantage. So he says that the cassette is threatening all men who take risk. They take risk to gain something, not to give freely. And he compares his mind as a golden mine. He says a golden mine stoops not to show of dross. The golden mine that he has, he says, I'm of a noble kind. I will not lower myself to consider this worthless thing such as lead. So he moves away from there. He moves away from there and he goes towards the silver cassette. He says, a golden mine stoops not to show of dross. I'll then nor give nor hazard aught for lead. I will not give any risk. I will not give any of my belongings, and I will not take any risk for lead. He moves to the silver cassette. He reads what is written in the silver cassette. What is the silver with its virgin hue? Okay. When he says what says the silver, he means to say silver cassette. And virgin hue, the bright shine, the white color, pure color shine of the silver cassette. White is a sign of purity. White is a sign of virginity. So he says, what says the silver with its virgin hue? Who chooseth me shall get as much as he deserves. As much as he deserves. Pause there, Morocco. So Morocco is made to think, because the statement says as much as he deserves. Morocco thinks that he deserves a lot of things. And then he pauses and he thinks and he says, and weigh thy value. Pause there, Morocco, and weigh thy value with an even hand. What does he mean when he said value with an even hand? He says being impartial in your judgment, in your estimation. Estimate whether you really deserves Portia. He comes to the conclusion, but he doesn't want to admit it. He comes to the conclusion, he said he deserves a lot, but he falls short of deserving Portia. He comes to the conclusion, but he doesn't want to admit that conclusion. See what he says? If thou best rated by estimation, thou dost deserves enough, and yet enough may not extend so far as to the lady. So he comes to the conclusion that he is unworthy for Portia. But again he checks himself. He doesn't want his emotions to play on his mind, on his heart, on his decision. And so he said, and yet to be afeard of my deserving were but a weak disabling of myself. if I go according to the conclusion of what is written there, I'll be disabling myself. Why have I come so far? I've come so far to win Porsche. I don't want to be disabled by that. As much as I deserve, then he thinks of the positive side of what the cassette says. Why that's the lazy lady? He feels now that he deserves the lady because of his birth, because of his fortune, because of his qualities of breeding. But more than that, he says he deserves Porsche because he loves Porsche. Do you really think that he loves Porsche, or does he love Porsche's outward appearance? Again, I feel that he again is going for the outward appearance of Porsche. How much does he know Porsche to love her? He is fascinated by Porsche's outward beauty, and that is why he says, but more than these in love, I do deserve. He asks himself, what if I strayed no further but choose here? But he makes the better of it and he moves further. Let's see once more this saying graved in gold. Who chooseth me shall gain what many men desire. Why? That's the lady. All the world desires her. From the four corners of the earth they come to kiss this shrine, this mortal breathing saint. When he reads the golden cassette, he estimates, he comes to the conclusion that who chooseth me shall gain what many men desire. He says, oh, that's very clear enough. Everybody desires Porsche. It's a very clear hint that the gold cassette holds Porsche's portrait. He says that people, suitors from all the corners of the world, all the four corners of the earth, are coming to kiss this shrine. Now, what is this shrine? When he says this shrine is a place where, what is a shrine? A shrine is a place where any sacred relic of a holy person is kept. Pilgrims kiss their relic to show their respect. So what he means to say that the gold cassette is the shrine. The gold cassette is the temple in which Porsche, the holy relic, is kept. So he concludes that the gold cassette is the shrine and Porsche, who is the saint, should be inside the gold cassette. Why? That's the lady, all the world desires her. From the four corners of the earth, they come to kiss this shrine, this mortal breathing saint. Mortal living, breathing saint. Mortal means the one who has not yet died. The Hyrcanian deserts and the vasty wilds of wide Arabia are as thoroughfares now for prince to come view fair Porsche. He further describes that people take great risk, great pain to come and see Porsche, as if it is a daily affair of crossing a simple road, as if it's just a thoroughfare, just a regular road. They are willing to cross the wilds of the Hyrcanian deserts and vasty and many wild wilds of wide Arabia, and as if ये रोज की रोजमर्रे की जिंदगी है, रोज आना जाना है उनका, उस प्रकार से एज इफ दे कम एवरी डे जस्ट टू कम एंड व्यू Porsche, जस्ट टू कम एंड हैव अ ग्लिम्स ऑफ Porsche. द वॉटरी किंगडम हुज एम्बिशियस हेड स्पिट्स इन द फेस ऑफ हेवन इज नो बार. नो, वॉट इज द वॉटरी किंगडम? द माइटी ओशंस एंड सीज. द स्पिट इज द वेव्स दैट मूव अप टुवर्ड्स द स्काई. सो दीज आर नो bars for people who want to come and see Porsche to stop the foreign spirits, but they come as over a brook to see fair Porsche. He's comparing the mighty oceans to a small brook, a small river. One of these three contains her heavenly picture. Is that the lead contains her? It were damnation. He never ever thought that lead, the leaden casket, can have Porsche's portrait, because he felt that the lead was too meager. बहुत ही सस्ता मेटल है, इसमें तो Porsche की तस्वीर तो क्या उसके मैयत के कपड़े भी रखने की औकात नहीं है? दैट्स वॉट ही फील्स. इट्स लाइक दैट द लेड कंटेन्स हर इट वर डैमनेशन टू थिंक सो बेस अ थॉट इट वर टू ग्रॉस टू रिब हर सर क्लॉथ इन द ऑब्स्कर ग्रेव. सर क्लॉथ इज द ग्रेव क्लॉथ, द क्लॉथ विच इज when the mummies are tied, na, the bandages with the mummies are tied, that's called the sir cloth. Or shall I think in silver she is immured, being 10 times undervalued to tried gold? So why does he refuse the silver cassette? Because the silver cassette is 10 times undervalued than gold. Oh sinful thought, never so rich a gem was set in worse than gold. So what he means to say that if Portia's portrait is to be kept, is to be kept in something more precious than gold. Even gold is worse for her. He means to say that Portia's portrait should be kept in something more precious than gold. Oh sinful thought, never so rich a gem was set in worse than gold. They have in England a coin that bears the figure of an angel. Then he recollects that in England there is a coin which is engraved with the figure of an angel, stamped in gold. He says, but that's inscribed upon. But here an angel in a golden bed lies all within. Here an angel in golden bed lies means referring to Portia's portrait. He refers to Portia as an angel and Portia's portrait as an angel lying in the golden bed means lying in the golden cassette. Lies all within. Deliver me the keys. He's so confident he asks for the keys. Here do I choose and thrive I as I may. Thrive I as I may. What does this mean? Whenever, whatever my success may be, he is willing to choose the gold cassette. Portia. There. Take it, prince. And if my fortune lie there, then I am yours. Portia is very glad to happily give away the key to the golden cassette. And she very clearly, because she knows that her portrait is not in the gold cassette. She very happily gives it to her. There, take it, prince. And if my form lie there, what is my form here? Mean her portrait, then I am yours. He opens the golden cassette. Morocco. Oh hell, what have we here? A carrion death within whose empty eye there is a written scroll? I'll read the writing. So he is very, very shocked to see what is there. He exclaims in an exclamatory way. He says, oh hell, what have we here? He never ever expected that anything else than Portia's portrait would be there in the gold cassette. He could not believe his eyes what he sees. He sees a skull, and in the eye socket of the skull is a scroll. But he has the courage. He's a really brave man. He has the courage. He takes the scroll and he reads. What does he read? All that glisters is not gold. Often have you heard that told. Many a man his life has sold, but my outside to behold. Gilded tombs do worms enfold, had you been as wise as bold. Young in limbs, in judgment old, your answer had not been inscrolled. Fare you well, your suit is sold, your suit is cold. So the scroll has something which very clearly defines Morocco. It is in this scroll that we understand how wise Portia's father was. What he foresaw, he knew that Morocco and the likes of Morocco would be coming to try their hands at Portia. And he was sure that people with outward bravery, with outward attraction towards outward beauty would definitely come and choose the gold cassette. And accordingly he has written that all that glisters is not gold. Jo dista tasa nasta, jo jaisa dikhta hai waisa hota nahi hai. In many languages there are phrases warning people of the outward appearance, going by the outward appearance of a personality, not to judge the book by its cover. All that glisters is not gold. Often have you heard that told. It has been told to y'all many, many times, but we still, when the time comes, we forget this advisable phrase, this proverb, all that glisters is not gold. But yet, we fall into a trap after hearing this, after being told so many times, we fall for the outward appearance. All that glisters is not gold. Often have you heard that told. Many a man his life has sold, but my outside to behold. Who is the my here? It is the gold, the outward beauty. But my outside to behold. Gilded tombs do worms enfold. Gilded means tombs with gold plate. Tombs, what are tombs? Graves. Even if the grave is made out of gold, if the outward of the grave is made out of gold, what lies inside the gold, that is more important. And what lies inside the graveyard? Of course, when the body decomposes, the rotten remains of the decomposed body, worms are there, even if the grave is made out of gold. So what is inside matters more than what is outside. That is what Portia's father is trying to convey to the suitor who chooses the golden cusset. Gilded tombs do worms enfold. Had you been as wise as bold. Here, this statement, see, he knows that a very bold person will come to choose a cusset. All those with weak heart will never dare to choose the cusset because they will listen to the terms and condition, and like the suitors who had come earlier, will refrain from choosing the cusset. He knew that a bold person only will choose a cusset. Therefore, he mentions that if had you been as wise as bold, right? You are a bold person, you are a brave person, but you are not a wise person. If you had been a wise person, you would have a second thought. You would have thought again before choosing the gold cusset. Had you been as wise as bold, young in limbs, in judgment old. Young in limbs means strong, bodily strong, your hands and legs full of energy, full of vitality, but your judgment should be of that of an old person. An old person is an experienced person who has seen the world. He knows what is good and what is bad for him. He has experience with him. He has wisdom with him. So, at the same time, you have to be strong, bold, courageous, but have a judgment of an old man, of a person who has seen the world. Had you been as wise as bold, young in limbs, in judgment old, your answer had not been enscrolled. This would not have been your answer. That the answer that you have in your scroll, this would not have been the answer. Perhaps if you had used your discretion, if you had used your judgment, you would have not selected the gold cusset. And this would not be your fate. This would not have been your destiny. Fare you well. Your suit is cold. Means you have chosen the wrong cusset. Your suit is cold means you have chosen the wrong cusset. And your hope is dead. When a person dies, his body turns cold. In the same way, your hope. He had come with a hope of winning Portia over. Winning Portia as his bride. So his hope, he has no hope right now. His hope is dead. Morocco adds to the verse that is written ahead. Morocco seems to be a poet himself. He adds to it. He says, cold indeed and labor lost, then farewell heat and welcome frost. Portia, adieu. I have too grieved a heart to take a tedious leave, thus losers part. So he very gracefully admits his loss. He says, cold indeed and labor lost. All his hope is gone. All the labor, all the pain he has taken right from Africa, he's coming to Europe, all the way from Morocco to Belmont, which is close to France and Italy. Belmont, of course, is a conquered kingdom. There is no place as Belmont. It is Shakespeare's thought that has made a city by the name of Belmont. Geographically speaking, historically speaking, there is no place as Belmont, but we presume that it is somewhere in Europe, somewhere close to Italy, somewhere close to France, because the story revolves around that area. Cold indeed, and labor lost, then farewell heat and welcome frost. Portia, adieu. Adieu means goodbye forever. Alvida. Portia, adieu. I have too grieved a heart. Too grieved, too painful a heart. Sad heart. I have too grieved a heart to take a tedious leave, thus lose a spot. Tedious, formal, in a way of formal, the way the kings and princes depart. He says, it's too tedious. My heart is too grieved. I'm very sad, so I cannot do the formalities. And this is the way that losers have to part. He exits with his train flourish of cornets. Portia, a gentle riddance. Draw the curtains, go. Let all his complexion choose me so. So Portia said, it's a gentle riddance. It's a good way to get rid. Okay, it's a good way to get rid of Morocco. Draw the curtains, go. She tells one of her servants to draw back the curtains. And look at the last statement. Let all his complexion choose me so. So this shows a sort of partiality on the part of Portia. It shows the mentality of the people that dark is not beautiful, black is not beautiful. Because here she talks about the complexion, here both colors and personality. It means here, in this, what Portia wants to say is not only the color but also the personality of Morocco. She talks of his kind. Let all of his complexion choose me so. It is not only targeting black people, but it is targeting those who have such thoughts of outward beauty, of outward bravery, of outward showy nature. Portia doesn't want a husband who is dark in color and has a dark personality, a personality which boasts of himself or thinks too much of himself. So therefore I have taken act 2 scene 2, and immediately after act 2 scene 2 I have taken act 2 scene 7, because they are connected, and we can reflect back upon act 2 scene 2 when we are reading act 2 scene 7, because it makes a flow of it. There are many other scenes in between from act 2 scene 2 to act 2 scene 7 which takes us away from this scene. This is my personal choice, please. Every teacher teaches in a different way. This is my way of teaching, and that is why I have taught you immediately after act 2 scene 2, I have taken act 2 scene 7 to make it easier for me to convey the chapter to you. I hope what I have explained to you is clear to you, and you have enjoyed listening to it as much as I have reading it to you all.